yesterday. As we start our service today, we pray for your presence. Can someone speak in tongues for 2 minutes? Reka daba zete liba bada bahanda. Reka dosta liba zata rabo zahada bahande. Lika mazeke lebo shande rabo zaya. Leka mazete lebo handa rabo zaya. In the name of Jesus, makuta raka tabo zaya. Leka mazeke lebo tarabo zaya. Itaboke lebo zata raka. Reke zekele mazoto lekayanda. Reka mazele batolo kayanda rabozia. Reka doska ni mazara kaya dara bukia. Renata mazeke lebo tanaka yana. In Jesus mighty name. Hallelujah. Pigia Jesus makofi mazuri. Amen. Pigia Yesu makofi mazuri. Are you there? Appreciate the Lord. We clap all fine wherever you are. Jesus is good. Appreciate our praise and worship. But apia makofi. They are so beautiful. They look at Jesus. Hallelujah. Wamekaka wameisua, hallelujah. They have been Jesus.
Amen.
In fact, I'm saying is that Jesus, it means that they look like Christ. But Pastor Regina never gave me a hint today is a black thing. Other speakers said it is a black. Continue. Hallelujah. Talk to your neighbor and tell him or her, you are fearful and wonderful, man. Mwambia you look awesome. Hallelujah. Mwambia you are so blessed to overcome corona.
Ay,
mwambia you are so blessed to overcome corona. Glory to God. Bless him or her in tongues. Lakuzaka laka. Tadula lakuka kaba. Leki bebo saka kabo. And he must deliver a message. Lazima never tell him what the Lord is here. You know, there was a time that a certain place was saying the glory of the Lord is here. Hallelujah. Now it's not only the glory. He himself is here. He himself is here. It is making noise in a boiler. Good, thank you. So welcome wherever you are watching us from, whether you're in America, South Africa, Australia, Europe, Canada, Seattle, California, Delaware, akina kuna mama aliniambia na watch akiwa Kansas, hallelujah, Kansas City. And whenever you're watching us from Malaysia, Greek, may God bless you as you watch this. Those are watching right now, and those who will watch after this, I declare the supernatural breakthrough in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Amen. You never mentioned all of these ones. Hallelujah. We may be seated in the presence of God.
Amen.
I want to teach about the topic that I'm calling the preaching of the cross. May God give me grace. I've been talking since yesterday evening.
Mungu atusaidie. Okay, ninataka kufunza kuhusu daraja ama daraja ya msalaba.
Preaching the cross. Preaching of the cross.
Mahubiri ya msalaba.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And on the cross for our series.
Nimekuwa nikiangalia sana kuhusu msalaba.
So I want Madeline to be prepared to read as many verses as possible. And you be blessed as you listen.
Na utabarikiwa unaposikiliza.
If you are the first time comer, we like so much here.
Kama wewe ni wa mara ya kwanza, huwa tunaandika sana hapa.
So we like writing. Only Jenny, most of the times he's read, he forgets, so I have to remind him every Sunday. Hallelujah. So glory to God. Thank God because mercy leo amemkumbusha. The preaching of the cross. Open with me in the book of 1 Corinthians.
Mahubiri ya msalaba.
Chapter 1 verses 17 and verses 18.
Wakorintho wa kwanza mstari wa
1 Corinthians chapter 1 verses 17 and 18.
Wakorintho wa kwanza mlango wa kwanza mstari wa 17 hadi 18.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
1 Corinthians 1:17. For Christ did not send me to baptize, but to preach the gospel.
For Christ did not send me to baptize, but to preach the gospel. I want you to understand that the main message and the main assignment and the purpose of every Christian is to preach the gospel. God has called us to himself so that we can preach the gospel. Pastor, what is the gospel? The gospel is the good news. The gospel is about the death, burial, resurrection, ascension, and the glorification of Jesus
Christ.
The gospel is about death.
Let me
come again so that people can understand. The true gospel is about this. Jesus was crucified. Jesus died on the cross. Jesus resurrected on that day. Jesus ascended in heaven.
Yes,
he is sitting in the right hand of the Father. Being glorified. That is the true gospel. Gospel is not about 10 ways to make it. It is about the cross. It is about the finished work.
Theology,
and they have done something that we call critical science. Hallelujah. That they link between the ranks. They don't believe about the soul, spirit, and the flesh. They believe on the soul and the flesh. They don't know nothing about the spirit. They think that we are like animals. The difference between you and animal, animal does not have a spirit. It has a soul. Hallelujah. So the gospel that we preach is not about the wisdoms. That is why when Jesus was appointing the apostles,
he went to
the darkest people.
Hallelujah.
Amen. He went on the left.
People who are not
sitting on the song of Abyssal. You don't need education to be educated. You don't need a university degree to catch a fish.
Unajua uhitaji degree ya kusoma sana ndio ushike samaki.
So Jesus brought us simplicity.
Kwa hivyo Yesu alienda katika njia ya chini hadi ya chini.
Wakati Yesu alisema kwamba kujeni ninyi wote mliolemewa na mizigo mizito. Kwa maana mila yangu ni nyepesi na rahisi. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Kwa hiyo ni Jesus is not too heavy for you to carry.
Yesu sio mzito sana kwako kumbeba.
Jesus is not so complicated.
Yesu hana ugumu wote.
Hallelujah. So continue reading for us. Next verse.
Verse 18. For the message of the cross.
That is where I am today. For the message of the cross
is foolishness.
For the message of the cross, or for the preaching of the cross
is foolishness to those who are preaching.
Is foolishness
to those who are perishing.
To them that perish. If you see a person who despises the gospel, he is perishing. He's not buried, he's perishing. Hallelujah.
Amen.
But you see a person
ukiona mtu
despising the gospel,
ambaye anadharau injili,
he's not buried, he's perishing.
Anapotea.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So the preaching of gospel, it is foolishness to the unwise. The preaching of the cross is wisdom to them that has known the truth. We who have been delivered from the kingdom of darkness to the kingdom of the marvelous light, Moses is the man. Abraham was the first person to pray for a person who is seen to be healed.
Abraham alikuwa wa kwanza kumwambia mtu mgonjwa apone.
When Pharaoh had a prostate cancer, he was told by God, tell that man he's a prophet to pray for you.
Wakati Pharaoh alikuwa na kansa alikuwa pia na pia kuombea.
How many of those leaders were the first person to resurrect people?
Wangapi wanajua Yesu wako wa kwanza kufufua wafu?
Do you know that?
Unajua hivyo?
Elisha resurrected a person.
Elisha
resurrected a person.
Elisha alifufua mtu.
Don't you remember that? So Jesus never broke a record for that.
Kwa hivyo Yesu hakuvunja rekodi.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
He never broke a record by being carried by a donkey. There is a man who spoke with a donkey.
Hakuvunja rekodi kwa kubebwa na yule mwanapunda.
So that did not matter. That was not the center of the gospel.
Kwa hivyo hiyo haikuwa ati ushindi wa
Yesu. But most of the times we center to the things that Jesus did, we forgot, we forget about. Angel turn from an angel to a devil.
Unaweza ona kuhusu huyu mtu vile alivyobadilika kutoka malaika mpaka kwa shetani kwa kitabu cha Isaia 14.
And I want to tell you this.
Na nataka kukuambia hivi.
That after the sin of man,
ya kwamba baada ya dhambi ya binadamu,
there was a necessity of cleansing.
Kulikuwa na umuhimu wa kutakaswa.
And cleansing was done through the blood.
Na kutakaswa kulifanyika kupitia damu.
Because the Bible says,
Biblia inasema,
in everything according to the law,
katika kila jambo kulingana na sheria,
they were cleansed by the blood.
Walikuwa wanatakaswa na damu.
Is it Rabboka nini for us? Hebrews chapter 9 verses 20 or 22. Hallelujah.
Kwa Ibrania 9:20-22.
Hallelujah. So, I have it for us.
Hebrews 6.
9. Yes.
Verse
20.
Verse 20.
Uh-huh.
It says, he said, this is the blood of the covenant, which God has commanded you to keep.
Verse 22.
In fact, the law requires that nearly everything.
The law requires nearly everything.
Be cleansed with blood.
Be cleansed.
With blood.
With
blood.
Be cleansed with
blood.
Blood. According to the law,
kulingana na sheria,
everything has to be cleansed.
Kila kitu kinahitajika kusafishwa.
With blood.
Na damu.
Instead of water.
Badala ya maji.
We cleansed through blood.
Walitakaswa kupitia
damu. And without shedding of blood. There was no remission of sin.
Hakukuwa na utakaso na msamaha wa dhambi.
Hallelujah. Amen. Hata without shedding of blood.
Bila kumwagwa kwa damu.
There was no remission of sin.
Hakukuwa na msamaha wa dhambi.
Now I know.
Na sasa ninajua.
No matter how you cry before the Lord.
Haijalishi utalia
kiasi gani. Your sins cannot be forgiven by your tears.
Dhambi zako hazikuwezi kusamehewa na machozi yako.
Your tears are so salt to cleanse the sins.
Machozi yako yako na chumvi sana kutakasa dhambi.
Your mourning and confession of sin cannot cleanse you.
Kwa wale zako na kukiri kwa dhambi hakuwezi kukutakasa.
So when God reaches down to forgive you, when you confess your sins,
wakati unakiri dhambi zako
to the priest,
kwa
tumishi, your sins are not forgiven because of confession.
Dhambi zako hazisamehewi kwa sababu ya kukiri.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
The only thing can wash your sins away.
Ambayo inaweza kuondoa dhambi zetu.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
It's only the blood.
Ambia jirani yako ni damu tu.
Not your confession.
Sio kukiri kwako.
Kutubu kwako. Kulia kwako. Kufunga kwako. Mimi kuna wakati nilikuwa nimefunga 7 days nisamehewe dhambi. I thought it was about me.
Nilifikiria ni mimi.
And I felt that I have been forgiven.
Na nikahisi kana kwamba
a self lie because of ignorance.
Nikafikiria nimesamehewa na kumbe ilikuwa tu kujidanganya tu.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
How many of there is a time niliambiwa uchukue chumvi na maji umwage nyumba yako na ukaamini ya kwamba hiyo nyumba imepanasika. Na ulifanya uganga, wewe ndio mganga. Sema imenisaba alafu imenyobaji. Wacha uganga. Kiana kwenye mtu anakuangalia ujia saiti kwa kutubi na mwaka mwaka.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
But that one cannot cleanse you.
Lakini hiyo haiwezi kusafisha.
The only thing which can wash you.
Ile kitu tu ambayo inaweza kukusafisha.
Is the blood.
Ni damu. Katika agano la
kale
na kwa kama sheria za Musa,
to explain this one like teaching love and preaching. And in the old covenant,
katika agano la kale,
the high priest,
yule kuhani mkuu,
had to take a lamb,
alilazimika kuchukua mwana kondoo,
and he had to detest the lamb and the goat or the lamb and look whether it has a blemish.
Are
we together?
Yes.
I want a man here. Let's come here. Man, let's come here. Why do you want to go to Hallelujah. Guru Mahapa, Guru Mahapa. This is our land. Hallelujah. I'm the high priest.
I just want
one sinner to come. One sinner, just one. Oh, just come. Tomorrow, I must put down your sinner. This is one sinner. Hallelujah. So, the sinner.
Huyu mwenye dhambi,
I told you according to the book of Mark chapter 7 verses 20
kutoka mstari wa 20.
What makes you a sinner
kile ambacho kinakufanya mwenye dhambi
is not what you do today,
si kile ambacho unatumia.
It is what Adam did,
ni kile ambacho wao watu,
and defiled your heart,
ambayo kinajisi
moyo, and after your heart was defiled,
na baada ya moyo wako kunajisika,
then what came out of your heart defiles you. That is malice, that is gossip, that is evil desire, fornication, among others. Those things make you a sinner. So, and because they are making him a sinner,
kama umetenda It is not. Alleluia. One, two. So, listen to this. Listen to this. If Kamakondo, Haina Mawawa, you are declared clean. It doesn't matter how drunkful you are. It doesn't matter how fornicated you are. It did not matter how you lived. But no matter how you lived, what mattered a lot is the state of the lamb. Is the lamb blameless? Is the lamb clean? Then the wages of sin is dead. So all the sins were counted on the lamb, not the man. Hallelujah. Oh, your neighbor, my sins have not been counted on me. They are counted on the lamb. Hallelujah. Oh, your neighbor, your sins have been counted on the lamb, not on you. Hallelujah. There is no need of condemning yourself. There is no need of condemning yourself. As long as you know, at the end of the year, I have the lamb. I will not die. The lamb will die for me. So you are assured to live another year because of the lamb. You are getting me?
Yes.
Tunashikana?
Yes.
This is it now. To pick your condom off.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And what I want to tell you this, that within the parameters of salvation, every year, that's not my mind. Every year, kila mwaka. Wait a minute. Hallelujah. Niyo ingine. Hallelujah. Wait a high. High kule tu kabisa. One, two. Okay. Every year.
Kila.
Wait a minute. See ya.
And there was no man in the world
that
there is nothing, I'm sorry to say this, there is nothing like the God the Father, the Son.